lot about the way that people talk about kind of meaningless as opposed to meaningful sex, you know? And people always say this in a way that kind of ascribes that there's some sort of idea of like meaningfulness ascribed to sex if you sleep with someone that you're in a relationship with, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or like that you really love. And this is somehow better, you know, this is somehow like a thing that you really want.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know, I've just been thinking about this a lot in terms of these kind of questions.
When my daughter was being potty trained, and she was about, she must have been about two, one and a half, two, and she was in training pants. And so, you know, the whole idea was that as soon as she thought that she needed to go to the toilet, she was going to say, you know, that she needs to go to the toilet, and then we would be quite quick. And I was out with some friends in the morning, and she had her children, and I had my daughter, my son was, I think, must have been in the buggy still.
How old's your son?
Oh, he's about 2 years younger than she. No, so in fact, he might not have even been born, actually. I just remember with Louise, her suddenly saying, "I need to go to the toilet, I need to go to the toilet." And so I whipped her up and I popped her into the loo, you know.
Mm-hmm.
The idea being I was going to sit her on the toilet so that she could do what she needed to do. And unfortunately, she was too quick, you know. So she did a poo in these training pants.
So I'm sort of holding.
That's what they're there for. But we were in the loo at this point, so I was trying to tip it out of the training pants so that I could then clear it up. So it, well, just so that I could sort of sort her out, you know. And I tipped it out, and I missed, and it went on the floor. And there was this quite a large turd went on the floor. At which point I lost my balance, and I put my foot in it. And it stuck to the bottom of my foot. And so I didn't want to put my foot down again.
No,
it was on my, it was on the bottom of my shoe. And I couldn't put my foot down. I'm holding her balanced over this toilet, standing on one leg with this lump of poo on my foot. And at that point, I felt totally out of control.
Did you drop? How did it end? Did you drop anything?
No. In the end, I just
managed to get everything.
I hit my foot on the toilet and got it down the toilet. And then I kind of sorted her out, and then I sorted her, you know, a bit of time. But just at that particular moment, I remember that feeling of just being, being completely overwhelmed, just thinking, well,
I didn't know this.
That's a good story.
At the time it wasn't.
So what is the, what? How did they know what to do?
I'm not sure about that.
You don't know?
But actually I was just somewhere else. On Monday I woke up in a tent.
In Wales. A tent?
Yeah.
In Wales?
Yeah, and it was raining all night. And it was really cozy to be in that tent with the sound of the rain. And I had the futon and the proper duvet there. Mm. And then when I woke up, I had to get out of the tent at some point, so I opened the zipper and then it was still pouring with rain, and so, and there was a lake in front of the tent. Then I went down to that lake and took my clothes off and jumped into the lake, and there was a real moment of just refreshing and really connecting somehow with fully being present with my body and in that environment.
Was it cold?
It was cold, yeah. I did go into a hot shower afterwards. But it's just this moment, you know, when you feel like you're just fully present and your mind and your body really connect. I think those are moments that somehow, yeah, make me feel satisfied, or so it's just like make life worthwhile.
Why did you choose that story to tell me?
Because I was just there, actually. I was just
remembering.
You were
remembering, just thinking about it? Interesting. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I do remember.